How do you use LiveDocs in MEMOQ? Coming up. Hello and welcome back to the Freelancers. Thanks for coming back to the channel. I hope you're doing well. Beautiful spring day here in Belgium, so perfect day to record the next episode of the feature series of cut tools that I do on my channel. I always do this at the example of MEMOQ. MEMOQ is sponsoring this series. Thank you very much for that. I have done translation memory, TM, and term-based TB so far, and today is probably one of the most underrated, undervalued, but super useful feature of MEMOQ, of cut tools in general. In MEMOQ, it's called the LiveDocs. LiveDocs is essentially reference materials, so it serves as a bucket where you can add anything to the project that could be useful for the translator to use. It then serves as a quick reference context viewer, basically, because everything you add to the LiveDocs as reference, you can use and you can search in while you're translating. I will show you everything on screen in a second. There are a couple of things you can add to LiveDocs as a reference. One of them, probably the most useful that I use the most, is bilingual files. So if you have a source document and a translation of that, but you know, you just have the documents, not the actual, you know, package, MEMOQ package, Rados package, XLIF, whatever, you can import both of them into LiveDocs and then do the alignment. I will show you how the alignment works. Essentially, what MEMOQ does, it looks at the length and at the context of every sentence, and it matches them with the source. So the target is matched with the source, and then it aligns the most likely combination of sentences, and these sentences are then put into, you know, into a context viewer, so you can actually search them. The alignment you can also edit. If you have a document that is a bit hard to align automatically, you can go in there and edit the alignment. You can also add monolingual documents. So if you have something only in the target language that could be relevant to your translation, maybe another document, like if you do a contract, maybe you have another contract with another product or another client that uses similar language, you can use that and you can search in it. If you already have finished translations from other CAT tools, for example, if you have an SDL XLIF, you can import that into your LiveDocs and you can use it in your translation. And you can also add binary files that are not usually being translated, such as audio files, images, videos, just things that give context to what you're actually working on. So what this essentially does is it adds everything into your CAT tool project, so you don't ever need to exit your work environment. You can look up everything in the environment so you can work faster and better, in other words, more efficiently. What's really cool about corpora in LiveDocs is that you can search them in concordance. So concordance search is something you use anyway regularly in a CAT tool, mostly in TMs. But there, when you search a term, you find maybe a match, maybe a 80%, 100% match, but you don't really see anything around it, no context. Maybe if you do proper TM management, you see in the corner down there, you see like which project it was in, which client it belongs to, but that's pretty much all you get of the context. However, if you do a concordance search in a LiveDocs document and you find a match, you have the option to right click and click show document, I think the UI is called, and it shows you the actual match within the context of the larger document. The same goes if you're finished with a translation, you can tell MEMOQ to send your finished translation into a corpora in a LiveDocs. You might think to yourself, why would I do that? Because it's already in a TM, right? But if you also add it to a LiveDocs, then you can leverage the same content in many different ways. Yes, if you have it in your TM, you can always find the match, but if you have it also in your LiveDocs, you can have the match plus the context. So that could be useful in the future, and it's not really an additional step to add your finished translation into your LiveDocs. It's just one click, so why not do it? Yeah, that's it. Enough talk. Let's see what this looks like in practice. I have a fresh batch of MEMOQ here and I will create a new project. I just upload a normal Word file just to show you how this works. I call this oranges. I ask ChatGPT to create a little text about oranges for us. That's a really cool use for it because I was always struggling, like what kind of text can I use that are copyright free, and I don't want to just take a text from my clients or from anyone's website, so I just used ChatAI to create it, which is great. Orange's EN for English is imported. I'm gonna add my translation memory that I created once for a previous video. I don't think there is a lot in there, but I need to add one, so I'm just gonna do that. All right, now, this video is all about LiveDocs, right? So here on the left side, you see this little drawer. It opens when you hover over it. This is LiveDocs. And many people will maybe not use that at all when they translate. I still use it not enough. So when I did research for this video, I learned a lot of things and I will now use it more definitely. I can go on here. So either a company will send you a translation package in MEMOQ, and then it might have LiveDocs in it, right, as references. Or if you create the projects like we do now here, you can add the LiveDocs yourself. Now, I asked GenAI also to create a text about lemons, both in English and in German. So I will use that to import into my LiveDocs and to align them so that I can use them for potential matches. So I don't have any corpora in here yet, so I click on Create New. Now, this is a new corpus, properties. It will be local on my computer. That's fine. Let's call it lemons. Corpora created, and within that I can now import documents. You can have several corpora and you can use them for different projects, right? And if you want to use lemons again later, you can just click here and activate it. But now it's empty, so you need to import something. So if you have, for example, a monolingual document, you could just simply import document and that's it. But now I have both an English and a German document and I want to align them so they match each other, right? So for that, I go down here. This is basically the lower part is the content of the corpora that is open. So I right click on here and I click add alignment pairs. And then add multiple files for alignment opens up. Now I can add source documents here on the left and add target documents on the right. So on the left, I add my Lemons English document. And on the right, I add my Lemons German document. And then I click OK and I import them. Now we have a document in the Lemons LiveDocs corpora. Let me open that to see what it looks like, if the alignment went well. Okay, yeah, it went quite well, I think. So here you see the link, the green thing. It recognized that the first sentence belongs to the second one, the second sentence belongs to this, etc. Now, if I recognize the mistake here, of course, this was a very simple Word file, so MEMOQ is very good in picking this up. But in some other harder documents, maybe it's a bit like juggled up or something. So if the first segment was actually, the third one was actually corresponding to the first translation, I could mark them and create a cross-link here. And then you can see that it creates a link that this is actually this translation. Now, I don't want that, so I do Ctrl-Z, but just so you know, if you want, now this was a simple document, so I don't need to change anything, but if you want, you can go in and actually change the alignment. That's what people call alignment. It's very useful for future translations. It's a very good translation management approach to do that regularly, to align your translation, so you have a clean TM, a clean LiveDocs, etc. If you are in this view and you checked all the alignments, you should click up here, Confirm All Autolinks. That means it's actually confirmed, and MEMOQ then knows that a human tested it, so you will get much more percentages in the links, so you don't get the penalties for untested links. And when you're done, you can click up here on the left, alignment is finished, and then MEMOQ knows this document is fully checked and it can use 100% matches. So now we can go back to the document, to the Oranges document. Now, of course, it will not show up immediately here in the translation results because the text is quite different, but it does have similarities. It's all like this explains oranges, the other ones that explains lemons, so there will be some overlap. So if we go now in the concordance search on translation concordance, we can search in the LiveDocs, right? There is nothing in the TM, but if I search here now Zitrone, which is German for lemons, I will get a lot of results from the alignment that we just did, right? Even though there is no translation memory with nothing, anything remotely connected to citrus fruits, I still get a lot of links. So for example, there will be a segment about desserts in the orange document, and I know that there is one in the lemon document as well. So if I look for the German word for dessert, which is Dessert, probably in the plural then. Yes, I get the link from refreshing beverages to tantalizing desserts. Lemons add a unique touch that elevates any dish. And stuff from this match I can definitely use in the origins documents as well. So that's basically what LiveDocs does, right? It adds the opportunity to find other matches. And the cool thing is now I can right click on this match from the LiveDocs and I can click open document. That's completely different from translation memory matches, right? Because if I click open document, it takes me to the alignment panel of this document. So I see exactly what came before and after. I see the full context. Then, as I said, you can add monolingual documents as well. Here, the lemons, the target document of lemons, I just added as a document. I can open this and it opens it in a Word. That's really cool. Obviously, I would not add that again if I already, like, I just have this document now, but I could add anything I want. I can add a video of a lemon, a picture of a lemon, I don't know, lemon tree, the song. I don't know how that would help, but anything you want, you can add into this lemons corpora, and it helps the translator to work more efficiently because he or she has to look for less references outside of cut tools, right? Now, I feel like it's also a bit our job to educate our clients with this feature, because I know that a lot of my clients don't know about this or don't know how to use it properly. And they send me reference documents, you know, just by email because they think it's the easiest way, but it's actually not, because if I get it on their system or by email, or I need to look it up myself, I constantly have to switch between windows, right? So it's much easier if I would tell the client, hey, you know what? This previous translation just added to the MEMOQ package as a LiveDoc. Or this video explaining the source, it's really useful, but you know, you can just add it to the LiveDocs. This image explaining how the corporate structure looks like, the hierarchy of the company, really useful, just add it to LiveDocs. So all of these things are just, it creates a hub of information where I can go as a one-stop shop that I know everything that there is to know about the translation. And even the web search within MEMOQ I can use. That's probably another feature that I will make a video about it once. And if I have all of this incorporated, I don't really need to leave the environment anymore. And that's the ideal working environment to work efficiently. There you go. As I said before, I need to use LiveDocs more and more efficiently as well myself. So I hope this gives you also some motivation. If you decide to invest in MEMOQ yourself and look at their Translator Pro product that is specifically made for freelance translators, check the link in the description. Thank you so much for sponsoring the video to MEMOQ. Amazing that you're always supporting the channel. I appreciate it a lot. And I thank you all of you for watching it. And I see you next Monday with the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.